learning lessons from what we see would be a way forward. So, if we move on to professionalism, I think the literature has disappeared. There we are. There are two concepts of professionalism. There are some subsets, but two concepts, and there are tensions between those. The first concept is professionalism as a societal concept, as a mechanism for social coordination. And what happens here is it enables skills and knowledge to be disseminated to our students to take into society, and then they can provide social goods, education, health care, and so on. So that's one view, one concept of professionalism. There is another one, which is about professionalism as a portfolio, as a suite of values and dispositions and ideas and knowledge bases. And what we have there is the identification of attributes which comprise a set of standards which we all say that is good professional standards delivering good professional knowledge. Now, they should support each other, but one of the issues is that all sorts of things get in the way. I've put some of them there. Power, identity, motivations of individuals, groups for status, identity, self-esteem and financial rewards. If you think about it, what happens in my profession, the accountancy profession, you form a body, you set knowledge standards, you put hurdles and barriers that people have to get over and force their way through to become a member. They stick with the rules. You try and stop the... You limit the admissions so that the salaries can stay high. You invent a whole series of terminology and codes of conduct which the outside world finds it very difficult to deal with.